bow break, let it come down, crash. Let the sun fade out to a dark sky. Can't say I'd even notice it was absent. 'Cause I could live by the light in your eyes. Unfold before you what I've strung together. The very first words of a lifelong love letter. Tell the world that we finally got it all right. I choose you. I will become yours and you will become mine. I choose. Time when I would have believed them. If they told me you could not come true, just love's illusion. But then you found me, and everything changed. And I believe in something again. My whole heart will be yours forever.
To be the other half of you. Tell the world that we finally got it all right. I choose you. Yeah. I will become yours and you will become mine. I choose you. I choose.
You look so wonderful in your dress. I love your hair like that. The way it falls on the side of your neck, down your shoulders and back. We are surrounded by all of these lies, and people that talk too much. You got the kind of look in your eyes, as if no one knows anything but us. Should this be the last thing I see?
Friends, we come here today at the invitation of Jason and Casey to share in the joy of their wedding. The outward celebration that you will see and hear today is an expression of an inner love and devotion that they have in their hearts. You see, today is a special day. You know, marriage is a special gift that it should never be entered into lightly. In the time that Jason and Casey have been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown and matured. And now they've decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. And that's why each person in their family has placed a rose in this unified bouquet to represent the individual love and presentation and preparation and influence upon their hearts of these two. You know, in Scripture, Jesus reminds us that in the beginning, the Creator made us male and female and said, for this cause, a man's going to leave his father and mother and shall cleave, be united to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. And Jason and Casey come today desiring to be united in this sacred relationship. And so, Jason and Casey, I'm going to ask you to declare your understanding that you know what you're getting into, first off, and intentions to enter into this union. All right? So, Jason, do you take Casey to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her for better or worse, for richer or poorer, sickness and in health, forsaking all others, being faithful only to her as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do.
I do.
All right. Casey, do you take Jason to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and health, forsaking all others, being faithful only to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right. And who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her family and I.
Jason, you're going to go first. Here we go. And just repeat after me. But don't look at me. Gotcha. Casey. I, Jason, take you, Casey.
I, Jason, take you, Casey.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
Richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you this promise.
I give you this promise.
All right, now Casey, here we go. I, Casey, take you, Jason.
I, Casey, take you, Jason.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you this promise.
I give you this promise.
Casey, I give you this ring.
Casey, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of the Lord.
I honor you in the name of the Lord.
There you go. All right, Casey, take this. Place it on his hand. And repeat after me. Jason, I give you this ring.
Jason, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of the Lord.
I will honor you in the name of the Lord.
May these rings be a sign and symbol of your love and devotion to each other. Now that Jason and Casey have given themselves to each other in solemn vows before us and before God as witness, and have shown their affection and trust by giving and receiving of rings and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. Amen. And Jason, you may kiss your bride.
How's that?
All right, turn this way. Dear friends, it is a great pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jason Adams.
So in love. So in love. So in love. You look so beautiful in this light. Your silhouette over me. The way it brings out the blue in your eyes is the Tenerife Sea. And all of the voices surrounding us here, they just fade out when you take a breath.
want you to know it's enough for me. Cause all that you are is all that I'll ever need. So in love, so in love, so in love, so in love. Ooh, Mia, darling.
So Henry already introduced me, but I am Chris. I'm the brother of the bride. And earlier I was given the opportunity to walk Casey down the aisle, which I knew for a while, and I was prepared. But then I was asked to give tonight's wedding toast, but with a little less time to prepare. 5 days ago, to be exact. So I do have a cheat sheet. I apologize. And hopefully fairly short and sweet for everybody. Jason and Casey, I just have to congratulate you both on planning and putting together such a wonderful, elegant, and joyous occasion. I know it took a lot of work from you both, and we are all delighted to be here. And again, I am proud and honored to be a part of it. Casey, obviously, I've known you my whole life and could probably come up with a number of qualities and adjectives to describe you. But the things that stand out to me the most is your loving, kind, and forgiving spirit, and that you've always had a bit of independence and strength that I admired in you. I love you, and I'm so happy for you. Jason, or should I say Woody? I learned that a lot this week, so. Woody, I've had the pleasure to get to know you more and more this year. And I would have to say the major thing that stands out to me about you and what I knew made you different were your true gentleman qualities. And I believe that being a gentleman is a matter of choice, and you've shown it over and over again. In fact, that's how really this true love story started. As Jason and Casey were on their trip to Ecuador, not knowing each other at a time, he offered to, I believe, help her with her luggage. And I guess history from there. Who knew they had to travel to a third world country to find true love? And they only lived an hour apart. So everyone, please raise your glass. Jason and Casey, this is my toast to you. I wish you all the happiness, health, and prosperity in your marriage. And may your love be added. May it never be subtracted. May your household multiply. And may your hearts never be divided. Congratulations. Get back to dancing.
All the things you are to me, darling, you have set me free. I'll always give you what you need and what you deserve. All the joy and all this love, together there's enough to fill.
We love you, and now we drop it on your heart. Woo! Olivia said, what? Say hi, Katie, hi, Uncle Jason. I love you, give him kisses. Mwah!
Things that you do.
Thank you.
I thought I was supposed to chant. Are we supposed to chant something?
No. Go Dawgs.
Okay.
Friends, we come here today at the invitation of Jason and Casey to share in the joy of their wedding. The outward celebration that you will see and hear today is an expression of an inner love and devotion that they have in their hearts. You see, today is a special day. You know, marriage is a special gift that it should never be entered into lightly. In the time that Jason and Casey have been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown and matured, and now they've decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. And that's why each person in their family has placed a rose in this unified bouquet to represent the individual love and presentation and preparation and influence upon their hearts of these two. You know, in Scripture, Jesus reminds us that in the beginning, the Creator made us male and female and said, for this cause, a man's going to leave his father and mother and shall cleave, be united to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. And Jason and Casey come today desiring to be united in this sacred relationship. And so, Jason and Casey, I'm going to ask you to declare your understanding that you know what you're getting into, first off, and intentions to enter into this union. All right, so Jason, do you take Casey to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her for better or worse, for richer or poorer, sickness and in health, forsaking all others, being faithful only to her as long as you both shall live? If so, say I do.
I do.
All right. Casey, do you take Jason to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and health, forsaking all others, being faithful only to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right. And who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her family and I.
Here it is.
Mm-hmm.
So I asked Jason and Casey if there was a passage of Scripture that they wanted to serve as a blessing or guide for their marriage, and so I'm going to share a few of those with you guys today. So the first one comes from Ecclesiastes 3, 1 through 11, and so listen to these words. There's a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to uproot, a time to kill, a time to heal, time to tear down, a time to build, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to search, a time to give up, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, to tear, and to mend, a time to be silent, a time to speak, a time to love, a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. What do workers gain from their toil? I've seen the burden God has laid on the human race. Listen, He has made everything beautiful in its time. He has set eternity in the human heart. Yet, no one can fathom what God has done from beginning to end. As you get to know these two more and more, you begin to see the things that are most important to them. You know, you see a journey from both individually of what it looks like to grow in their trust that God's timing is actually perfect. You know, getting to hear their story, one of the things that became so incredibly apparent is that as Jason and Casey took seriously their relationship with Jesus and learning what surrender to Him actually looked like, He began opening doors. You know, by them keeping their eyes set on Jesus, He opened doors for them to actually find each other. You know, waiting on God's timing is not easy, and honestly, it makes you look a little crazy to those around you at times, right? But to trust and hope and wait on Him is the key to experiencing promises that we hear like in Ephesians 3:20. Now to him who's able to do immeasurably more than we could ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us. It's an amazing thing to realize, finally, that God not only can do immeasurably more than we can imagine, but that he actually wants to, right? And so his word says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans for hope and a future." He wants what's best for you. In fact, he's not surprised by what's taking place here today. Instead, he's delighting in it because he actually likes you guys, you know? He's a loving father, wanting to give good gifts to his children. Today is a new beginning for you. So the question is, how do you invest in this marriage, to last for a lifetime? You know, once this day is done, once the honeymoon is over, how does this relationship continue to get better each day? You know, Scripture introduces us to a pretty interesting idea that is contrary to what our culture likes to believe. You know, we're instructed to choose what to devote our minds to choose what to do, and then comes a promise. You see, for some reason or another, there's a misunderstanding about what love actually is. You know, many people believe that healthy marriages last because two people feel so in love with each other for all the time. And yes, feeling in love with each other is important, all right? You know, that is a big deal. But listen, feelings are not strong enough to sustain a relationship. And in fact, at times, your feelings and emotions deceive us. You know, in Scripture, there are several words that teach us about what love is. There's a word, eros. You know, and it does refer to our feelings. It's an emotional, very passionate, short-term kind of love. You can't sustain a relationship off of an eros kind of love. There's got to be a greater kind of love. And in 1 Corinthians 13, Paul says there is a greater, more significant, a more excellent way to love. And in that beautiful passage, he uses the word agape, right? And many of you, I know you guys know it. It's this powerful kind of love. It's a love that's willing to sacrifice one's own needs for the needs of another. You've probably heard that it's unconditional kind of love. It's not reciprocal, doesn't need your approval from the other side. I'm going to love you regardless. Maybe the best way to think about it and to understand it is that this is a kind of love that leads us to do what is in the best interest of the object of our love, regardless of how we feel. You see, God's word teaches us that an agape kind of love must be put on, meaning it's a choice. In fact, it bears the image of clothing oneself with this kind of love. Now, I hate to bring this up, but Casey, there's going to come a day when you wake up and you turn over to this man, Jason, and he's not going to look as good as he does right now. But let me just say, Jason, you look great. The wedding diet has really paid off, man. And again, Jason, believe it or not, there's going to come a time when Casey does something that will make you not want to naturally love her. I know that seems impossible, but there will come a time, and it's in these kind of moments where you choose to love, where you choose a more excellent way to put on agape kind of love. You see, when it comes to marriage, we get our cue from Christ. He's the one who set the example for us on what it looks like to choose love, because he's the one who humbled himself to be with us, to make right what had gone wrong. He's the one who showed us what compassion actually is, reaching out to us. The reason we practice these things in marriage is because Jesus first showed us how to do these things and showed us that it works. So clothe yourselves with love, because this is how you invest in a marriage that is going to last. Too many people have said, follow your feelings. But if we take to heart what Scripture actually says, that if you choose to love first, oftentimes our feelings follow. And so love does not come easy, but that is why we're instructed, especially in our marriages, to put on love. That is why our vows are so important, this part of the covenant that you guys are entering into. And so these vows are verbal expressions of your commitment to one another before God. And so you have become to be made husband and wife. Now turn to each other and hold hands together. And let's enter into these vows. Jason, you're going to go first. Here we go. And just repeat after me. But don't look at me. That's Casey. I, Jason, take you, Casey.
I, Jason, take you, Casey.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
Richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you this promise.
I give you this promise.
All right, now Casey, here we go. I, Casey, take you, Jason.
I, Casey, take you, Jason.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you this promise.
I give you this promise.
And there are rings to seal these vows. You know, these rings, though small, carry great significance with them. You know, being made in a circle reminds us that true love, agape kind of love, it never fails, and it has no end to it. And as you wear these rings, whether together or apart, may they be a constant reminder of the promises that you are making today. And so as a ceaseless reminder of this hour and the vows taken, Jason, let me give you this ring right here, and place it on her hand. And repeat this after me. Casey, I give you this ring.
Casey, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of the Lord.
I honor you in the name of the Lord.
There you go. All right, Casey, take this. Place it on his hand. And repeat after me. Jason, I give you this ring.
Jason, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of the Lord.
I will honor you in the name of the Lord.
May these rings be a sign and symbol of your love and devotion to each other. Symbol of the two individuals coming together as one. You know, from the very beginning, we understand marriage to be a covenant where God unites husband and wife as one. And the Lord's Supper is also a symbol of unity. And all who have put their faith in Christ are united together in Christ under one Lord, one Spirit, one purpose. And so when believers take the Lord's Supper together, we remember Jesus' sacrifice, that he gave his life for our sins, and we remember the covenant that he made for us, and that any of us who accepts that sacrifice and commits our life to following him receives forgiveness, and through Jesus' death, and we receive also eternal life. And that's a proclamation that Jesus is the center of our lives. And so as Jason and Casey, as you guys take the Lord's Supper together, you guys are doing this as a visible sign that Jesus is the center of this marriage, and he is the one who is culminating this new life together. And as you came in today, some of you took some of the communion cups as well, and we want to invite you to participate with us as they take the Lord's Supper now.
Just do this? Should have tested these, huh?
Okay.
Join me as we pray together. Here we go. Father, today as we ask your blessing on Jason and Casey, as husband and wife, we pray that you will watch over them. We pray that you will encourage them, that you will take care of them. Continue to work on them individually as well as together. Give them patience in time of struggle and wisdom in times of difficulty. Keep them ever mindful of your presence, and in the name of Jesus we pray this. Amen.
Amen.
Now that Jason and Casey have given themselves to each other in solemn vows before us and before God as witness, and have shown their affection and trust by giving and receiving of rings and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. Amen. And Jason, you may kiss your bride.
How's that?
All right, turn this way. Dear friends, it is a great pleasure to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Jason Adams.
Finally!